Please all stand as we begin our Eucharistic celebration.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Have mercy on us, O Lord.
For we have sinned against you.
Show us, O Lord, your mercy,
and grant us your salvation.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who manifests your almighty power above all by pardoning and showing mercy, bestow, we pray, your grace abundantly upon us, and make those hastening to attain your promises heirs to the treasures of heaven. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of Job. Job said, pity me, O you, my friends, for the hand of God has struck me. Why do you hound me as though you were divine and insatiably prey upon me? Oh, would that my words were written down. Would that they were inscribed in a record, that with an iron chisel and with lead, they were cut in the rock forever. But as for me, I know that my vindicator lives, and that he will at last stand forth upon the dust, whom I myself shall see. My own eyes, not another's, shall behold him, and from my flesh I shall see God. My inmost being is consumed with longing. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
Hear, O Lord, the sound of my call. Have pity on me and answer me. Of you my heart speaks, you my glance seeks.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
Your presence, O Lord, I seek. Hide not your face from me. Do not in anger repel your servant. You are my helper. Cast me not off.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
I believe that I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus appointed 72 other disciples whom he sent ahead of him in pairs to every town and place he intended to visit. He said to them, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest. Go on your way. Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. Carry no money bag, no sack, no sandals, and greet no one along the way. Into whatever house you enter, first say peace to this household. If a peaceful person lives there, your peace will rest on him. But if not, it will return to you. Stay in the same house and eat and drink what is offered to you, for the laborer deserves his payment. Do not move about from one house to another. Whatever town you enter and they welcome you, eat what is set before you, cure the sick in it, and say to them, 'The kingdom of God is at hand for you.' Whatever town you enter and they do not receive you, go out into the streets and say, 'The dust of your town that clings to our feet, even that we shake off against you.' Yet no, the kingdom of God is at hand. I tell you, it will be more tolerable for Sodom on that day than for that town." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, let me remind you that doing mission or becoming missionary is not only for priests and religious sisters. Because everyone by virtue of his or her baptism is missionary. Ang bawat isa po, dahil sa ating binyag na tinanggap, ay misyonero o misyonera. Hindi na kinakailangan umalis kayo ng Pilipinas. Kahit sa inyong mga pinagtatrabahuhan, kahit sa inyong tahanan, kahit sa paaralan, kahit sa palengke kung saan kayo nagtitinda, pwede kayong maging misyonero. Pero may babala ang Panginoon. Sabi niya, Behold, I am sending you like lambs among wolves. He is telling his disciples and us that it is not an easy job. You will face rejection. You will experience persecution. At alam niyo naman yan, di ba? Kung kayo ay makita na nagdarasal sa opisina, minsan ngingitian kayo ng inyong makasama, pero may halong pang-aasar. Kung gumagawa kayo ng mabuti dahil yun ang narinig ninyo sa simbahan, may mga taong pag-iisipan kayo ng masama. Kapag nagsasalita kayo tungkol kay Kristo, kay Jesus, maaaring yung iba umalis. Pero pag pinag-uusapan ang buhay ng kasama sa opisina, nako, nagkakagulo. Pag pinag-uusapan ang buhay ng isang artista, nako, ayaw maghiwa-hiwalay. But once you begin talking about Jesus, some would say, ay, may gagawin pa pala ako. Those are the things that Jesus knew would be happening to His disciples. There will be rejection. And the Lord is saying that, okay, when that happens, leave that town, go to another town until you find people who are receptive to your message. Huwag mong ipagpilitan sa tao na ayaw. Ipagdasal mo siya upang siya'y magkaroon ng liwanag at maintindihan ang kahalagahan ng Diyos sa kanyang buhay. But let me remind you, all of us, not only me, all of us are missionaries. And imagine how the world will be, how society will be, if all of us will become true missionaries and disciples of the Lord. Sabi pa nga ng Panginoon sa Ebanghelyo, into whatever house you enter, first say, peace, peace to his household. Every missionary is or should be a bringer of peace. Tagapagdala, tagapaghatid ng kapayapaan. Kaya nga mga minamahal kong kapatid, yan siguro ang magandang biyayang hilingin natin sa misang ito. Panginoon, lagi mong ipaalaala sa akin na ako'y misyonero, na ako'y misyonera. Please, Lord, remind me that I should always try to be instrument of peace. Amen.
Please stand.
We now turn in prayer to the Lord of the harvest and pray for the needs of the church and of the world. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all the faithful may be aware that they are called by God to spread this kingdom of peace in the world. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be more conscious of our vocation to spread the good news of salvation to the people in our neighborhood. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That farmers who will till the soil and work the land may be blessed with good weather and abundant harvest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the sick and those who find life difficult may know that God cares for them through the concern of their families. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faithful departed who labored in this life may obtain their heavenly reward. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, help us to take part with joy in the work of spreading your gospel by the example we show in our lives. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant us, O merciful God, that this our offering may find acceptance with you, and that through it, the wellspring of all blessing may be laid open before us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in goodness you created man, and when he was justly condemned, in mercy you redeemed him, through Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Together we pray to our common Father in heaven in the words Jesus himself gave us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May this heavenly mystery, O Lord, restore us in mind and body, that we may be co-heirs in glory with Christ, to whose suffering we are united whenever we proclaim his death, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go and be missionaries.
Thanks be to God.